So for the next problem naman, if the soil exerts a trapezoidal distribution of load on the bottom of the footing, determine the intensities W1 and W2 of this distribution needed to support the column loadings. So, kung nag-solve ka na ng problem sa HGE, this might look familiar. Kasi yung HGE kasi, yung dams, statics and mechanics lang talaga yun. Kaya maganda talaga pag malakas yung foundation mo sa statics at mechanics, kasi yung RC sa steel magiging madali nandun. Basically, yung foundation, HGE, mga ganun, magiging madali. So, for this problem, given yung forces natin, but hindi natin alam yung W1 saka W2. Now, sa analysis ng dams, parang ito lang yung Q minimum, ito naman yung Q max. Pwede yung ganun. But since statics tayo, so let's try to solve this using statics talaga. Now, yung gusto kong gawin, if I have problems like this, is isosolve ko muna yung location ng resultant from the left. So what if label ko yan as barred x? And then, diba, dyan mag-a-act yung resultant natin. Now, the resultant force is the total. So, 80 plus 60 plus 50. This is 190. Yan. So, 190 multiplied by barred x must be equal to 60 multiplied by 1 plus 80 ito multiplied by 2.5 plus 1. Ito kasi yung reference axis ko. Yan, dyan measured yung x bar. And then plus 50 multiplied by 2.5 plus 1, 3.5 plus 3.5 magiging 7. Yan. So solving barred x, we have 60 plus 80 times 3.5 plus 50 times 7. Divide natin by 190. So we have 3.63. This is meters. Yan. Now, since alam ko na yung barred x, I can now develop equations para ma-solve ko yung W1 saka W2. So essentially, meron tayong dalawang unknowns. So we will need to use two equations. So my first equation would be from the summation of forces, the vertical forces. So I have yung area na lang ng trapezoid, di ba? Area ng trapezoid would be A plus B, yung parallel sides, divided by 2, multiplied by the length. So the length is 2.5 plus 3.5 magiging 6 plus 1 plus 1 magiging 8. So 8 pala yung length. Lagyan na lang natin. Yan, 8m. So yung first equation ko would be W1 plus W2 over 2 multiplied by 8 it must be equal to all the forces acting downward. So, 190. Yan. Nakuha kasi natin yung resultant kanina. So, simplifying this, we have 4W1 plus 4W2 equals 190. So, this is our first equation. Now, for the second equation, we can use moments. So, gagawin natin, we can divide this into two shapes. Now, the height of this is W2, while ito, this has a height of W2 minus W1. So, separating the two, meron tayong dalawang resultants. So, for the triangle, we have 1/2 times a base of 8 meters multiplied by a height of W2 minus W1. Yan. And then its moment arm, dito na lang tayo mag-moment. Yan, going to our reference line, this is 1/3 of 8. Yan. And then, for the rectangular load naman, excuse me, for the rectangular load, andito yan sa gitna. So, this is W2 multiplied by 8. And then, its moment arm going to the reference line is 1/2 of 8, or simply 4 meters. Yan. So, if I will take moments pala, sabihin natin, A, summation of moments about A, then we have 190 multiplied by barred x, which is 3.63, and then equal yan sa lahat ng counterclockwise moments. So 8W2 multiply ko by 4 meters. And then, ito naman, plus 1/2 times base 8 times height W2 minus W1 times the moment arm, 1/3 of 8 or 8 over 3. Ito na yung second equation ko. Yan. So, masosolve na natin yan. You can apply the two equations, two unknown sa calculator mo. But since madali lang naman yung first equation, yan, ito na lang gagamitin ko. So, essentially, I can make this W1 equals 190 minus W2 divided by 4. Yan. So, I hope agree lang. Na pala, meron pala tong 4. Tama ba? 190 minus 4W2, move ko siya sa right side, then divide by 4. Yan. So, meron akong equation ng W1 in terms of W2. So, papalitan ko yung W1 dito. So, copy ko na lang. And then we have W2 minus 190 minus 4W2 divided by 4. Then times 8 over 3. Yan. So input natin. equals 8W2 times 4 plus 0.5 times 8 times W2 minus 190 minus 4W2 divided by 4 multiplied by 8 over 3. Yan. So, solving W2, we have 22.43. Wait lang ah. Wala sa choices. 22. For a while. Sa-check ko lang. 4W1 plus 4W2 equals 190. Ito naman, 190 times 3.63, then 8W2 times 4, tama, then 1/2 times 8, then W2 minus W1 multiplied by 8/3. Check natin ulit. 8x times 4 plus 1/2 times base times W2 Wait na. Try daw natin i-simplify ito. Gamitan natin ng two equations, two unknowns. So ano yan? 190. Ba't iba? Equals 32W2 plus 1/2 times 8, magiging 4 yan. So 4W2 times 8/3 minus 4W2 times 8/3 pa rin. Yan. Simplify daw natin. Coefficient ng W2 would be 4 times 8 over 3 plus 32. Ano pala yan? W1. 4 times 8 over 3 plus 32. 128 divided by 3. Iba talaga. 4W1 minus 4W2 times 1/3 of 8. equals 32W2 plus 4W2 times 8/3 minus 6, 8, 9.7 equals 128/3 W2 sorry. Ano pala to dapat? W1 minus W2. Sorry, mali yung label ko. mas malaki yung W1 pala. Yan. Kaya pala mali. So, W1 minus W2. And then, pwede na yun kanina. Nako, hindi na save. Ito na lang. Copy ko na lang to. And then, change natin yung W1. But again, you can still apply the two equations, two unknown sa calculator. But then, you have to simplify a bit. Ito pala. This is W1. Yan. So, solve natin ulit yung W2. We have 190 times 3.63 equals 8x times 4 plus 0.5 times 8. Then 190 minus 4x over 4. Then minus x multiplied by 8 over 3. So, ito pala. Mali pa rin. Wala sa choices. Libre yung error. Wait na. 8x times 4 plus 0.5 times 8. Ah, 190 pala. Yan. Yan. 17.16. Ito na. And then, since meron na tayong W2, masosolve na natin yung W1. So, this is now 16. So, 190 minus 4 times ito, then divided by 4. So, 30.34. This is kN per m. Yan. So, W1 is eto. Then, ito yung W2. Music.